Welcome back. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to execute this Selenium script into the container. Okay, so this is a part 3. In part 2, we have discussed about how to install the containers and how to start the hub and nodes and all. So we are going to discuss about how to execute it. In this video, I have taken Selenium with Cucumber as my framework to execute into the container. You can use in Selenium with test engine also. That video also I'll create it. Right now I'm creating, I've created already so many nodes, you can see it. So this are the nodes, 6 nodes I've created. Some are basically headless and some are head one. Okay, so I'm going to execute in a headless right now. Before that, I'll execute in my local. So what I'm doing, I'm executing my parallel execution with the help of multiple runner class. There is a way of executing Selenium Cucumber multiple in parallel using a jar called Cucumber JVM parallel plugin. There is a separate video. If you go to my playlist called Cucumber with with Java, you can find Selenium in a parallel, Selenium with Cucumber with parallel execution. In this plugin, basically what is happening is like it will create multiple runner class based on the number of feature file. Suppose you have 100 feature file, it will create 100 runner class and it will execute, try to execute 100 browsers, which is not a possible. Your script, your machine will crash. So and also one problem is like you can execute in a single browser with that, but with a two separate runner class, what you can do it, you can define multiple browsers. Like I have taken two runner class, one I am defined Firefox, another I have defined Chrome. Okay, and it will execute in parallel, and just you have to put that into your Surefire two runner class. If you define 10 runner class, you can define 10 runner class. Even though if you don't put it, you give the half path, it will pick up all the runner class. Yes, I have defined it. Okay, regular expression I have used **. Now let me execute in my local. So these two scripts will get executed in a local. I'm just using Maven install. It will execute one in a Chrome, another in a Firefox. So let me close this Firefox and let's start executing. Until it's getting started executed, let's discuss about the grid. So I can ramp up my grid as much as possible I want. If I want to create more grids manually, I can create. I'll just add and run this command. So this will add more nodes. Okay, so I'll just put it, one more node will get added. Message is little slow. Not a issue, you see. So one in Chrome, another in Firefox. It'll start executing soon. Okay, as I told you, the execution will be slow. The reason behind, whenever there is a friction of seconds is a delay in like thread has got stop or got pause, another thread thread is executing another test cases basically. So two test cases, one has got executed, another it will start and it got executed. So you see two second one will started, I think. Yes, and hopefully it has executed also. I don't know, I have not checked it. So two will get executed parallelly into browsers. Okay, did I change the parameters or not? If I don't change the parameter, okay, one has got executed in a headless mode in a Firefox. Reason behind, I have put it headless, that's the reason it's not executing headless. Let me comment it and execute again, so it should be visible to us and we can see it. So you see how much time is taking to two browsers to get executing our local. Okay, now it's got finished. Okay, and it has the reports. So let me refresh it and take the reports. Okay, there is a separate video how to merge two reports, because I am generating two reports in two different folders. Okay, target one and target, because two runner class are running parallelly, independent. As I told, test case should be always independent, so both are running independent. You can see it. Okay, I have taken the screenshot intentionally. When I execute into the container, this should also take the screenshots. Okay, so let me change the parameter quickly. So I'll just put it S here, and in second runner class also I'll put it S here. Yes, so both will execute parallelly into the node. Okay, so I'll go into the form.xml and I'll just put it like this, so both should get executed my node. If I refresh this, so I can see some, you see, one more has come and it will start executing in my nodes. So now no more browser has opened here, and test has got a strategy, test 1, test 2, 2 runner class it has picked up. Okay, so until it is getting executed, let's go to this. Some more thing I'll just teach you. If you want to see how many are there, what do you call, Dockers are running, and if you want to stop and PS or restart, you can do it with a command called stop with a container ID. So you see here, so if I want to stop, these are headless, so I want to stop this too. I'll just do like Docker stop, and I can just copy their container ID, so it will get stop. Now if I go headless, one Firefox would be less, and if I take this one and say Docker stop, and this will stop it. Okay, this is how, so two less, it will remove the two, it should stop it. So it has stopped, look like. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 was there. Now when this gets refreshed, it will stop it. Okay, so execution has got finished. I can see the report. Refresh it. And I can see there is a report, and there is a open with, and you can see it got executed. So this is how we are stopping. I have stopped two servers here, two nodes basically, and that too in a this is a head one, headless one. These two are headless and these are head. Debug means head. So I'll just check here, it should remove two, just refresh, and two should get removed. So 4 5 6 7 are there. It's taking time to remove it. If I put my command ps minus, sorry, docker ps minus a, so two are got exist, you see, about a minute ago. And then if I refresh it, it takes some time to refresh, get the command, and you can log in to this server using a VNC. Okay, and you can see how the executions are happening. These are the servers got created, like it's a containers got created. You can log into the container with a user ID, password. User is this, and password is secret. By default, is a secret is a password. Okay, thank you for watching. In next video, we'll explain about Docker Composer, how to start in one command only. Thank you.